Hope everyone can hear me. If you can hear me, give me some sign of life. If you cannot hear me, don't give me the sign of life. I hope you can. Oh, I hear you. Amazing. That's what I love to hear. I apologize for my brief delay. As you know, I'm on the other side of the world. It's a little early. And just trying to run between calls here. So as customary schedule, I will start the call in 5 minutes. 5 minutes, I will begin the call no later than 5 minutes. We are going to begin in 1 minute. In 1 minute, we will begin. Shout out to everyone attending from all over the world. What are the crypto markets saying this early in the morning? It's not really that early. For some of you, it's really late. But for me, bright and early in the morning. Oh, Bitcoin is down 1.2%. Fabulous.
Now connected to Bluetooth.
All right. Without further ado, let's get started. Welcome everyone to the, I think like ninth annual, not annual, weekly. It actually happens 3 times a week. Ignite My Finances webinar hosted by yours truly, Shorupan. I am the CEO and co-founder of Invest, the parent company behind Global Exchange. I am also your gracious and honored host to be able to guide you through this webinar. If you are attending from the East Coast, it is 8 p.m. If you are attending from the West Coast, 5 p.m. My European friends, midnight. And if you're like me out here in Asia, sunny Asia, it is bright and early in the morning. But the great thing about the crypto markets is they don't care where you are. It is the opportunity that truly never sleeps. And on this webinar, we are going to show you how to make it an income stream that never sleeps with this incredible, incredible platform, but more importantly, by unlocking a business type that so many people overlook when they get into the cryptocurrency market. So guys, buckle up. It's gonna be a wild webinar. I'm gonna speak really fast as I usually do because there's lots of information. If you have questions, please shoot it out in the chat box, ask it in the Q&A, put up your hand. I will definitely make sure that everything gets answered. I am here to ensure that you guys get value out of this, no matter if you're a customer, if you're just looking at the platform, if you're a broker, if you're a potential broker. I want to make sure everyone learns on this webinar because this is a learning process for all of us. This is an education process. And that is what these webinars are meant to do. They're meant to show you how you, as a normal participant of the cryptocurrency markets, can take their business or their opportunity, take their life and ignite your finances. So how do I like to break these up? Numero one, I talk about the parent company, who you're getting involved with, just so we can get the formalities out of the way, just so you know who you're dealing with. Numero two, I look at the cryptocurrency market. I like to provide some analysis on it. Usually I talk about what is the golden goose opportunity within crypto that so many overlook. Today I'm actually gonna talk about what's the golden goose opportunity within crypto that everyone overlooks, as well as how to take advantage of a burgeoning and fragmented OTC market. Numero three, I look at the platform, look at the solutions that we're gonna solve, look at the effect that we're gonna take to solve these solutions, look at the technology that underpins some of this. And numero four, I look at how you guys get involved. I look at what what we offer in terms of getting people engaged with this market and how they can take advantage and take their finances to the next level. So again, guys, this webinar will be recorded. This webinar will definitely be posted. It is gonna be really, really fun. Let me start sharing my screen. Couple housekeeping rules. Number one, I talk fast. Number two, I use a bunch of jargon that only crypto nerds will understand. I apologize greatly for that. I don't do that on purpose. It's just become my first language. Number three, there will be people walking around behind me as we're transitioning from the overnight shift here into the daytime shift. And number four, let's just have some fun and learn something today, because that's the whole point. I am going to share my screen. Make sure you can see my screen. That is where I reference all the material. So where did it all begin for us? What do you want to know about us is, how did we get here? Why are we credible? Why can we do the things that we say that we're going to do? And who is Shorupan and who is Global Exchange? Well, to understand that, you're really going to have to look at our parent company. So in 2000, one second, let me hold this up. In 2017, I was residing in a country, Toronto, Canada is the city. I was born and raised there. My co-founder was born and raised there. And we had a vision. And our vision was, how can we make cryptocurrencies accessible to people that currently were not being targeted by other crypto companies? And who are those people? Those people are people that exceed the age of 30, that are not technically sophisticated. I call these people the uninitiated. And the reason I'm telling you that this was our mission back then, because this is still our mission today, even with Global Exchange. It's different, a business, different approach, same mission. Take crypto to the masses. He who takes crypto to the masses will win. In 2017, we saw the price of Bitcoin sharply increase, going from about $1,000 at the top of the year to about $20,000 at the bottom of the year. Any asset that increases at that velocity will get a lot of attention, will get a lot of smart and dumb money, will get tremendous amount of media scrutiny, will get a tremendous amount of media fanfare. But you know what it didn't get? Good infrastructure, because there was such a large amount of people that were still being left out. The biggest crypto companies in the world still left out so many people. So we launched Invest Bank, which is still available at investbank.com. What is Invest Bank? Invest Bank is a hybrid custodial banking software that allows you to hold your long-term crypto assets in both in both online and offline storage. It functions like a Coinbase in the fine sense that it lets you manage your portfolio. But more important than that, it functions like a Trezor, as it lets you take that custodial service you are taking from us and move it offline. What do I mean? We accompanied our online platform with offline banking branches. Yes. You heard it here. The same things your grandparents went to when they wanted to do a transaction, an offline banking branch. We have a retail strategy of acquiring physical brick and mortar branches as places of points of sale for Invest Bank. Our flagship one is headquartered in my hometown, Toronto, Ontario. It's a former TD Canada Trust, and this is what it looked like. If you're in the greater Toronto area, please book a time with myself or the support team to go visit that. It is a spectacle of a sight. That business really paved the way for everything else that we did in crypto after the fact. In 2018, we went on to launch the Invest Group, on the back of Invest Bank. We essentially wanted to spin off Invest Bank as an independent operating entity. And we wanted to take the two things we became good at, software development for custody services, as well as retail distribution or distribution networks in general, offline distribution networks, and externalize them so other companies can take advantage of them. In other words, we wanted to sell on an enterprise level what we became good inside of our own company at. And that essentially launched the Invest Group, which is a launchpad for blockchain companies. I call it the crypto factory, where you can come in or we will seek you out as a promising crypto venture, and we will acquire different stakes in your company by providing you everything from investment to development services to custodial services to really the basic infrastructure that you need to take your business off the floor. We've done that with 20 plus projects at this point. Obviously, the biggest one at this point being Global Exchange, which is what we're going to talk about on this call. But really, it's a wide basket of companies that really are taking on some incredible challenges in the crypto space. How do we do all of this? We have the largest network of R&D campuses for cryptocurrency, starting with where I am right now, Bangalore, India. We have the largest Invest campus sitting, which is where I'm sitting in right now. This is 130 person dev shop on the second floor. You can only see about 30% of it. The other 40% is in front of me, accompanied by a full-blown production studio on the first floor and a training academy for those same developers also on the first floor. This is the belly of the Invest world, where all of the ideas are incubated, built, and where companies are taken out of. And really, we are trying to emulate the same thing in multiple countries so that we can get close to the developers and get ideas out faster and smoother. That is the parent company out of which Global Exchange emerged. It has such a vested interest in the long-term success and adoption of cryptocurrencies. We are crypto through and through. And what we want to do is see the asset class thrive, not just because it means economic welfare for so many, including us, but because it provides a level of integrity to the financial system, which hitherto has missed that or has been bereft of that. With that being said, now is the segment of the presentation where I go into what is this opportunity? Why are we here? Why are we excited? Why are we investing millions of dollars? Why are we so jazzed up about this market? And the reason for that is because it's a secular trend. Those of you that don't know, or those of you that are wondering, how does someone in their lifetime jump economic stratas? How does someone in their lifetime go from here to here financially, legitimately? And the only way to do that consistently, the way that history has impugned upon us, the method to this madness is by identifying secular trends and then using those to catapult yourself into the next economic strata. And the way you do that is by taking advantage of it before everyone else finds out about it. This obviously happened several times throughout the 20th century, starting from the advent of automobiles all the way until the advent of the internet or the distribution of the internet at the end of the 20th century. It happened in the beginning of the 21st century when social networks and mobile phones became the driver, the growth engine of the world's economy. And it is happening again. And in my estimation, it is happening bigger, better, and more prolific with cryptocurrencies than we have ever seen in any of those other secular trends. And that is because cryptocurrencies are rewriting something so fundamental to the world, to humanity, which is transactions, not just currency transactions, any form of transaction. So this gets a lot of people excited. As I said, lots of people got excited in 2017, and they all got excited about one thing, and they were also terribly mistaken as to where they put their attention. They all thought they're gonna strike it rich by buying Bitcoin, or worse off, buying the next hot cryptocurrencies. And I can assure you, none of them had any success with that, because the real opportunity during a gold rush is not to dig for gold, as particularly not to dig for any other metal but gold, but is to build the picks and shovels to sell things to the people who are coming to dig for gold, to sell water, to sell t-shirts, to sell shovels, machinery, metaphorically speaking. Of course, you want to establish a real business within the hysteria of that gold rush. And those are the people that do that are the people that struck it rich in 2017, in 2018, in 2019, ever since the advent of cryptocurrency. Who are those people? But before I reveal those people to you, let me tell you what numbers you should really care about. And it is not this number. This number, 7,192, which exemplifies the price of Bitcoin today, is not relevant to you. If you are an owner of Bitcoin like me, still not relevant. If you are a long-term believer in Bitcoin like me, still not relevant. If all of your life savings are in crypto like me, still not relevant. Do you know why? The fundamentals, if you believe that there are any, that underwrite the success of Bitcoin has no pointed value at this number. There's nothing that told you Bitcoin was gonna be $7,192, not one chart, not one technical analysis, not one sentiment analysis. Trust me, nobody knows where this price is going unless you are the one perpetuating it. And at this point, Bitcoin is not beyond the point of manipulation, but definitely beyond the grasp of average manipulation. What Bitcoin means is a shift in the way that we do business. If you believe in it long-term, you will hold it long-term, and you know the price can be incredibly high. But trying to identify day by day, week by week, month by month, year by year, where it's going is madness, is actually the same type of lunacy that sucks people into lose money every time they see a secular trend. The numbers you should be more concerned about are up here in the forgotten bowels of CoinMarketCap. Number one, market capitalization. For those of you who know financial terminology, you know what that means. Market cap means the entire notional US dollar value of all cryptocurrencies. In other words, how much money has gone into crypto, period, as of today? That number, 195 billion US dollars. For those of you that trade or are invested in other financial assets, you will scoff at a mere 195 billion US dollars, because that there are many US equities, many US stocks individually have a bigger market cap than that. Obviously, the hard commodities, the FX markets, individually, each of them have tremendously large multiples over that. Really, $195 billion is a baby in the financial markets. And what does that mean for you? That means we're just getting started. It means that $7,192 is not even scratching the surface. It means that we are the rare few who care about this market far too early. We are the crazy bunch that believe that $195 billion market can change the world. And that's very important. The other important number, the number that's probably more important, indicative of your success, is this number, 24-hour trading volume, which CoinMarketCap tells us is 57 billion US dollars. What does this mean? This means how much money in US dollars worth of cryptocurrency traded hands yesterday. The last 24 hours, how much went from Bitcoin to Ether, Ether to Litecoin, Litecoin to Bitcoin, Bitcoin to Tether, Tether to MakerDAO, whatever your cup of tea is, 57 billion US dollars traded hands in the last 24 hours. The reason that's an important number, independently standing, again, not a daunting number, not an impressive number. The reason that's an important number is because of the percentage of market cap that was traded in the last 24 hours. That is over one fourth of the entire money in the entire asset class switched hands in the last 24 hours. There is no asset on planet Earth that has that type of economic reflexivity. That would be terrifying to most speculative hedge funds that are willing to play within the high volatility indexes. One fourth of all the money traded in the last 24 hours, unheard of, and will continue to be unheard of. The only reason that's possible is because of a framework that makes digital currencies easy to trade, 24/7 trading, highly liquid. And who provides all of that? Who has built the framework upon which this hysteria is self-manifesting itself? That's the club of people you have to join, the club of institutions whom you have to become one of in order to tap into the greatest opportunity that will invariably ignite your finances. Who are those people? They are exchanges, cryptocurrency exchanges. If you're a crypto enthusiast, you know them, you've used them, you hate them, you love them. What do? There are technology platforms where you can go trade cryptos, buy cryptos, sell cryptos, etc. Let's take a look at who these faceless people are. Lots of them are my friends, so I'm not saying anything negative about them. I am just exposing how lucrative their business model is. If you click rankings and click adjusted volume under exchanges, you will see who these players are. Oh my goodness. CoinMarketCap so graciously aggregates every cryptocurrency exchange by trading volume. I bet no one knew that. And that's because all 40 million people that come to CoinMarketCap only care about the price of Bitcoin or the price of their new hottest ICO coin that is frankly irrelevant. Really what they should be paying attention is this page. Number one exchange, the last 24 hours, talk. I will give someone $1 worth of Bitcoin if they can show me their talk account. Trust me, you have never heard about it and you have never used it. If you have, I will bite my words and I will give that $1 worth of Bitcoin. But again, I'm not saying that to actually throw shame upon them. I'm sure they're a good exchange, never used them myself, but the fact of the matter is you've never heard them. They're not sexy. They're not mainstream. They're not in your messages. They're not all over your screens. But in the last 24 hours, they did $1 billion in trading volume. What does that mean in terms of actual bottom line money? If they charge the basis point for fees, 0.01%, not 1%, 0.01%, they cleared $1 million yesterday. $1 million in profit without having to buy or sell or invest into any cryptocurrency. You did that on their behalf. A company that launched in June of 2018, a company that did $1 billion yesterday in trading volume, you will never hear of and you will never use yourself properly. Number two, P2P to B2B, another $1 billion, never heard of them. In the last 30 days, 30 billion. What does this show you? This shows you that there's a whole world of things you didn't know within the crypto markets. Oh, golden goose, you know, sunny fields of a business model that makes money, whether crypto is up, down, sideways, circles, doesn't matter. These guys get paid on transaction fees. So as long as you're interested in trading, they're interested in making money. So as long as you're interested in liquidity, they're interested in providing it. So as long as you want to believe you have the secret to getting rich in Bitcoin, or someone has convinced you of that, they're ready to give you the platform to do it on. It is by far the greatest model in crypto. It is the only model out of all the thousands and thousands and thousands of business models that have been proposed by ICOs or IEOs or whatever it is that actually works, that sustains revenues. It is because it is providing infrastructure to all of us. So, do these guys have the picture perfect model? Is it Mona Lisa picture perfect? Is it so great that you should get off this webinar, call your friend and start building an exchange? Well, there are two issues with them. And these two issues are the ones that we identified at Invest when we started to build Global Exchange. The first issue is there's too many of them. There are over 700 cryptocurrency exchanges, each of them with their own interface, each of them with their own set of tools, their own terminology, their own rules and regulations, their own technology. The average person does not wish to learn more than two platforms per technology. That is why you use Spotify or Apple Music or Tidal. That is why you use Netflix or Amazon Prime. That is why you typically only use Amazon for e-commerce. Maybe social media has defied that statistic, but not by much. Many studies show that one social media reigns primal in the hearts of each age demographic. So currently between the ages of 20 and 35, it's still Instagram. Between the ages of 15 and 25, where there's a little bleed over at Snapchat. TikTok is bleeding up into Instagram's territory. Maybe they'll overthrow them. The attention span of a human is not that great. The willingness to learn and adopt new technology of the masses is not great. 700 cryptocurrency exchanges will not work. Maybe one of them will work, but definitely 700 of them will not. So we saw complexity in the markets. We saw, whoa, the world doesn't need another exchange. The world needs simplicity. That's the first thing we want to tackle. I will keep coming back to that word. I will keep hearkening on that word. It is the word to remember. Number two, security. With all of these different protocols, how can you trust anyone? How can you trust any of these institutions? How can you trust the validity of their technology, whether it's custodial or non-custodial. Obviously, each of these platforms are centralizing large amounts of crypto assets, and there comes with that a level of security vulnerability. That's just basic computer science, basic database architecture. You put too much gold in one temple, that temple's gonna get robbed, even by the nicest person. You make it very lucrative to hack one system, trust me, you'll have a lot of people lining up to hack it. I've been on both sides of that equation. I know exactly the temptations that poor game theory will incentivize. And right now these guys are incentivizing extraordinarily poor game theory because they have a couple billion dollars worth of crypto assets on cloud computing infrastructure that is also used to store photos of your kids, for example. That's how basic some of this infrastructure is. It requires an advancement in security, a hybrid approach. Does that mean all of them are vulnerable? No, some of these companies are tremendous security. They have tremendous security, but there's 700 of them. And so security and simplicity. We knew we couldn't build another exchange. We knew we could easily build one and fail, but we knew we couldn't build one to succeed. And that was the inception of global exchange. See, what is global exchange? If you go to globalexchange.com, it's really simple. It's the world's first exchange operating system. What does that mean? Well, I coined the term exchange operating system 19 months ago. When I came to the realization that what's happening in the exchange markets today is exactly what happened in the personal computing markets, or even what's happening in the crypto markets today is exactly what's happening in the personal computing markets at the end of the late 80s. See, when personal computing became an inevitability, hardware, hard infrastructure, we call it close to the metal infra, was proliferating at a rapid scale. Chip manufacturers, semiconductors, hard computers, servers, these were the companies dominating the day, and they were becoming ever more complex. IBM, HP, Lenovo, Dell, you can keep going down that list. And what did two kids out of Harvard realize, Bill Gates and Paul Allen? Or maybe they didn't realize it, maybe they just executed better than everyone else. That, oh my goodness, if we wanted to put a computer on every desk, none of this can actually be what the customer understands. None of this can actually be what the customer interfaces with. What needs to occur is an interface revolution. In other words, we're gonna abstract away the hardware manufacturers, make them irrelevant, and build a common unified interface. They called it an operating system, whereby any user can access any application on the computer, any application can deploy straight to the user. They call that operating system originally Microsoft DOS and then Windows. Our operating system is called GX Nitrous. I'll show you a tour of that. In other words, we know that exchanges are valuable. We know that other protocols in cryptocurrency are valuable. Lending protocols, DeFi protocols, betting protocols, decentralized exchanges, you name it, it's all amazing. But what we also know is that you don't want to interface with all of them. You want to have a common platform, one interface you learn with that unifies that so you can solve your problems. That is how we plan on getting crypto on every desk, metaphorically speaking. And that's what global exchange does. It looks at the different verticals of crypto transactions, crypto interfaces with your exchanges, and aggregates all the players into one platform and builds you a unified user experience. Let's take a look at that unified user experience. Accompany me, shall we, to gxnitrous.com. GX Nitrous, our Microsoft Windows. If you go to GX Nitrous and log in with your username and password, which I obviously already have, you will see the interface. You will see the version, you will see V1 of our operating system. And this is what it looks like. It starts off by giving you this desktop homepage type of feel where you can get a quick read on everything going on in your cryptoverse. And on the left-hand side, it breaks down each vertical within the cryptocurrency space. And within each of those verticals, we've built custom apps, two-sided networks, where if you're an exchange, you can plug in your APIs so that people can access your order book. If you're a betting protocol, same thing. Lending protocol, same thing. Fund manager, same thing. It arrays off the cryptocurrency markets in compartmentalized form so that you as a user don't have to learn or even leave this platform. Everything comes to you, very much like a Google Play Store, like a Microsoft Windows. Let's take a look at one of the verticals, GX Trade, which is one of the ones that get the most, which is probably the most vaunted the most infamous one. And this is what we started off with. We wanted to aggregate all exchanges into one platform. Our API integrates with 170 different exchanges. Right now, you can see two that we're testing, still in beta testing, as you saw that prompt you explained to you. By the end of this week, if not early next week, we will leave beta testing and go into the first form of production testing, open this up to our network or our customers. What can you do here? You can actually trade directly on Bitfinex or CREX24 or about five other exchanges right now, fully integrated, 170 waiting to get integrated. This is not our order book. This is not our chart. This is not our price. We don't have an order book. We don't have a chart. We don't have a price. We are a routing engine. We've created smart order routing technology that allows you to trade directly on Bitfinex. Whatever asset you want that Bitfinex trades will appear here. You will have full access to it. You are now in control of the crypto markets that you want to trade on. You can look at everything from your order history, trade history, to your balances. You can obviously see everything that makes up the cryptocurrency markets from an exchange perspective. Let them come to you and you keep all the power. That's just one app within our OS. We've done that in multiple verticals and we're going to continue expounding on that, expanding in the ways that we do that and expounding on the ways that we can do that for the cryptocurrency markets. Just like that, we're tackling algorithmic trading, betting, lending, and investment funds. Some of them are in production, some of them are in beta, some of them are fully functional, all of them are accessible to our early users. If you think about that as a mall, that's why I like to think about it sometimes, a crypto mall where you can come go to H&M, you can come go to Zara, you can come go to Best Buy, you can come and play around with what you want. All the stores come to you essentially. You go to the mall, but all the stores come to you. The entry and exit point into the crypto world is, of course, what? Fiat currency. Whether we like to admit it or not, crypto won't work without fiat because everyone still has fiat. The great opportunity of the day is that there are trillions of dollars that are about to migrate from US dollars, fiat currency, into cryptocurrency. We needed a portal. We needed a way for you to get in quick. Right now, people are using everything from Coinbase to the local guy down their street. They're using everything Cash App in the US to their cousin Harry. How can we automate, systemize that entire thing, standardize it? That's our Vault product. Our Vault product essentially is the entry exit gates into crypto. In between those two gates, you can play in any of the malls, you can play in any of the playgrounds that we've highlighted. All the players will come to you. What does the Vault do? Vault is your standard onboard, offboard ramp for crypto. It's your portfolio management dashboard. It lets you top up your bank. It lets you top up your account in US dollars. This is key. Everyone gets a US dollar account. Soon we'll be issuing other currency accounts. As soon as you fund your US account, which you can do in a plethora of ways, three of which are fully functional now, bank transfer, e-transfer, and GX broker withdrawal, more options will be coming soon. As soon as you fund your US dollar account, you'll be able to buy, sell crypto instantly, getting in and out of many, many different cryptos and hedging your risk and accessing the world of crypto. Not only can you buy, you can also sell. You can transfer in your Bitcoin and sell your crypto directly back into US dollars or the other currencies we'll be offering. This is the onboard offboard ramp of the future as it simplifies everything. It's multinational. It's available domestic in multiple currencies. It is the simplest in my opinion. It doesn't offer rigorous testing of your identity. It is the easiest way to get onboarded. You can also buy up to $20,000 worth of crypto with credit card through our proprietary Insta Crypto purchase page, which is a website we set up for credit card direct purchases. This is what allows you to get in and out of crypto. Inside of crypto, you got the whole world to play here. And that's our vision. That's Global Exchange. That's GX Nitrous. That's how we plan on solving the two plot problems that I outlined earlier. Now the question is, how do you make money off of this? How do you go from being a mere participant in the crypto space to being an owner of this infrastructure? How do you go from someone that's running to dig for gold and looking for the next piece of gold to dig to someone that's owning the water shop down the line, down the way? Someone that owns the shovel shop down the way, someone who's making consistent transactional revenue. Well, that is where our distribution product comes in. See, we knew that in order to properly onboard the masses, just like we knew in Invest Bank that there had to be an element of physical branches to kind of make people feel comfortable, we knew that if you wanted to onboard the masses digitally, you need to think outside the box. Because the biggest players in the world, Coinbase, Finance, etc., are already doing it digitally. They've done it all. They've done everything you can do. Get licenses, get regulated, be in every country, unbelievable software, unbelievable execution speed, API documentation, every coin you can imagine. They got it all, but they haven't even started to scratch adoption yet. And the reason for that is that they believe that if you're interested in crypto, you'll come to them. Let me repeat that. They believe if you're interested in crypto, you will come to them. You will come to them and you will learn their platform. Now, once you learn their platform, they're hell of a platform, man. They are incredible. Especially if you live in a really established, you know, Western country, United States, Canada. Ooh, unbelievable platforms. But this is the issue. No one goes to them. I mean, obviously they have lots of customers. Those are just anomalies like me that are interested enough about a new speculative asset to go out of your way and learn. That is not the average person. In order to understand how you can adopt crypto, how the world can adopt crypto, you have to look at history. You have to look at where in history new assets were brought into the market. And what were the last assets that were brought? What were the last financial instruments that came into the market over the last 100 years? There's many. Insurance, mortgages, retirement investments, pension funds, hedge funds, private equity, derivative markets, spot trading, mutual funds, ETFs, etc., etc., etc. Everything that I just named, most people on this call know about, maybe purchased, definitely know someone knows that they can purchase, maybe their parents have bought it. The reason is because those companies weren't arrogant enough to believe that you were going to come to them. They came to you in the form of an agent, in the form of a broker, probably in the form of someone that came to your house, literally came to your house. See, financial instruments are not pull products. They're not McDonald's. They're not food. You don't wake up in the morning thinking about, oh my goodness, I need my insurance for the day. It's not like coffee. I need my coffee for the day. They're products that need handholding. They need simplification. They need someone to literally establish the need and then solve the problem. How do those instruments do it? Or the makers of those instruments? They had a network of brokers, an agnostic network of brokers, millions trained by the day, armies to go out and make sure everyone got educated. And over the last century, all those products became mainstream, even though they're more complicated than Bitcoin, probably more risky than Bitcoin. They're less well understood than Bitcoin, that's for sure. If you think you understand your insurance policy, let's have a conversation about that. Let's see how well you can explain it to me. Let's see how well you can explain to me how that insurance company is insuring that. Let's see how well you can explain any of those things to me. So I find it flabbergasting when people say Bitcoin is complicated. Compared to what? Maybe compared to real estate. It's kind of complicated because at least you can touch and real estate is more or less simple. But apart from that, every asset that you use, this modern financial system is built on complexity that was made simple by a network of brokers. And cryptocurrency had no such thing. Cryptocurrency had nothing like that. If anything, cryptocurrency had a bunch of fragmented partisan people that said that their ICO was the best, that said that their exchange was the best. That's not what you want to hear. What you want to hear is a person that cares about getting you into the asset class because they believe that the asset class can serve you. Of course, no one incentivized you to do that. The best thing that you had if you were a crypto influencer, someone that could drive adoption of crypto, is Coinbase giving you 10 bucks per user. That unfortunately is not going to cut it. So what did we want to do? We wanted to create the world's first crypto brokerage product that essentially allows anyone to go from being a user of global exchange operating system to being an affiliate, to being a broker. And as a cryptocurrency broker, you're able to manage this entire cryptocurrency, digital cryptocurrency brokerage without having to do anything. You don't have to build the software, maintain the software. You don't have to buy crypto and sell crypto. You don't have to collect payments or distribute payments. You don't have to worry about compliance, legal risk management, cybersecurity, hosting, etc. All you're doing is driving adoption to a platform that's free to sign up and takes 1 minute to sign up. Once you get them on the platform, they interact with the company. They are now exposed to trading on their favorite exchanges, to trading on their favorite DeFi networks, to getting access to Bitcoin, selling Bitcoin, things that they're already interested in doing or will become interested. Your job is done. Your job is now to sit there and collect the transaction fees that the other exchanges would keep for themselves. We pay out 100% of the transaction fees on every type of transaction. Not only that, if any of your customers end up becoming brokers, you override them infinite levels down. If you're interested in learning about how the math works on that, we've created a technology called Broker Chain, which essentially divvies up the transaction fees set by brokers in a way that it gets dispersed up the entire chain using a descending tricolon equation, which I hand wrote. It's very simple, but it's also very astounding when you look at it. We'll definitely release all of that information available in the public. Let's see how simple this actually is. Okay, to become a broker, you buy 1,000 tokens. There's no reoccurring cost. There's no monthly subscription. There's no fees, nothing. There's not even a startup fee. All you have to do is figure out how to get 1,000 GXT. What is GXT? GXT is our native cryptocurrency. There's 350 million of them in circulation. They're completely open source, built on top of the Ethereum network. You can go audit the smart contract today. All it regulates is how many people can become brokers. It essentially puts a supply on the top amount of brokers, because in order to be a GX broker, you need to stake 1,000 GX tokens. As soon as you stake 1,000 GX tokens, you unlock this broker tab. This broker suite of tools, of enterprise management tools. Everything else is available to you upon sign up. No, you don't gotta pay for anything. But to become a broker, you have to stake 1,000 coins. You ever wanna stop being a broker? No problem. Unstake your coins and sell them. As soon as you unstake your coins, your brokerage is no longer valid. As long as you stake them, as long as they're staked, you have unlimited earning power on everything that I said. As soon as you stake your coins, you get your brokerage apps. Click your brokerage apps on the first page of your brokerage apps, you get an affiliate ID. In this affiliate ID, or this broker ID, you're able to send out a custom link, checkout link. As soon as user signs up with this checkout link, in 1 minute, with no verification required, no credit card, no money up front, he's now gets access to GX Nitros, and he's appended to your brokerage forever. Every transaction he does within that platform, you're getting a piece. You can monitor everything from your GX broker statement, which is essentially your entire transactional log for global exchange. It shows you everything that happens. How much broke? Everything. You are now able to run a global cryptocurrency business without lifting a finger, without taking a single dollar's worth of your own risk, just by growing out a network of people that are already in desperate need of this service. This is how you can go and ignite your finances with no money up front, with no reoccurring cost, with unlimited income potential in the hottest asset class on planet Earth in a matter of minutes. In my opinion, it's the greatest business model in cryptocurrency for users. It is also the most important one, as our brokers are playing such a vital role in the field today. See, for us, for them, they're just making money by spreading the word. But for us and for crypto in general, they are the face. You know, people always said, who's the face of crypto? Is it Satoshi? Is it Vitalik? Is it Craig Wright? Nope. The face of cryptocurrency is our GX brokers, because they're the only ones in the field today going out and simplifying the message. And they don't care what coin you buy or what trade you do. They just want to help you get involved. Right now, we have about 1,200 GX brokers in 77 countries. You can go look at all of those analytics at pulse.gxbrokers.com, which is an open analytics tool. 1,360 brokers, forgive me. All over the world, they're starting to convene and spread this message. What's the message? Crypto is the most important asset class in the history of the world. You should get into it. How hard is it? Very simple to get into it. And they're doing that. They're doing that labor on a daily basis and being rewarded very handsomely for it. And essentially, that is how you ignite your finances, and that is global exchange. I will now open it up for questions. Someone is raising their hand. Do they actually want me to let them speak? I'm not going to put the hand back down. Any questions, ladies and gentlemen? Just pop my ears. That was bothering me the whole time. Guys, realistically, if this is not your first time hearing this, I'm glad you got to hear this one. I thought that was a really streamlined version of this. I think it covers everything that needs to be covered. We're really passionate about what we're doing here. A lot of great leaders are hopping on board, helping a lot of people, making a lot of money. Understanding the opportunity here is so great. Getting paid, being your own Coinbase, being your own digital asset exchange without taking any of the liability sounds pretty good. And really, all I recommend everyone doing, I don't recommend anyone buying anything. I recommend you signing up for free, help with the person that got you here, playing around with the system. If you like it, great. If you hate it, don't just leave. Please complain to us first so that we can make our system better. We beta tested this, we pre-launched it July of this year. And we've grown really exponentially since. And now we're really pumping out the infield sales. And based on that, we are going to drive out how 2020 looks. So I got some questions here. When can I get a recording of this? This is such a great webinar. I will put up a recording today when my community manager comes in. Now, can you speak a bit about how the benefit of the credit card orders? Sure, I can speak. I mean, the benefit of the credit card order is an interesting way to phrase that question. Essentially, we have credit card purchases available for crypto. Where's my GX Nitrous account? Right here. So if I was a user, I can actually just click this tab right here, or I'm pretty sure it's also in my buy crypto. Yeah, buy with credit card. And I can click this and it'll open up this website, Instacrypto purchase / my Uplines affiliate ID. Oh, sorry. Can't see my screen. Let me open up my screen again. Okay, so there are some great questions. Let me start with this credit card one, okay? So I'm in my vault. I'm a normal customer. It doesn't matter if I'm a broker or I'm not a broker. I can choose to purchase Bitcoin or any crypto by first topping up my US dollar account by funding it, bank transfer, e-transfer, etc. Or I can buy Bitcoin by purchasing it directly with credit card. Now, when you purchase it directly with credit card, you're using our third-party website, instacryptopurchase.com. You click here. It'll take you to the website. And on this website, you're essentially interacting with several payment processors, crypto-friendly payment processors, and you can buy up to $20,000 worth of crypto instantly. I hate this website, if I was to be completely honest with you. It is a great service to a lot of our customers, but it requires our customers to interact with their banks upon transaction. And what that means is that your bank has the ability to reject the transaction every single time. And most of the time, and this is what irritates me so much, I'm kind of ranting now, when you call the bank after, they'll be like, no, we didn't do it. No, of course they did it. No one else has the power to do it. They have automatic fraud triggers linked to cryptocurrency related payment processors. This is something people don't understand. Actually, the employee at the bank that you're talking to never understands either. If I have cryptos, they don't understand that either. So right now we have a success rate of credit card purchases going through about 65%, which is still miraculously high compared to how many banks don't want to push those less transactions through. And for those 65% that get through, this is the greatest service on planet Earth. Within 2 minutes, you're able to buy up to $20,000 worth of crypto with Visa, debit, or credit card without even having to create an account. Just put in your Bitcoin address. Or you can buy Bitcoin Cash and Ethereum and Litecoin. It's fabulous. However, it's not guaranteed because there's another party, Mr. and Mrs. Bank involved. And so we offer it and it's a fabulous service and it is as competitive as any of the other credit card processing services for crypto because they're all using the same payment processors. However, it irritates me because it still has its infrastructure, logistical inefficiencies. We are tackling every day to make this more efficient. We're already leading the industry when it comes to providing solutions like this. We're going to make it more efficient. We're going to talk about this in upcoming videos. As a broker, you make fees off of this as well, obviously. So that's how it benefits you as a broker. As a customer, it's a hell of a service. Who does the KYC? We do aggregated KYC when you're doing different transactions with us. We don't do KYC upon sign up, which is a really big benefit. If you're doing a credit card transaction, KYC is definitely done upon transaction by our payment processor. So let's see. Okay. Question about being grandfathered in. Yes, Nathan, please ask your question. Can't see your screen. Who does KYC? Okay, let me look at the Q&A. How long does it take to be approved as a broker once you stake your tokens? It's instant. You just click request stake. Like I have some GXT here, right? I have some like 230 GXT. If I just click request stake, it shows me that in my GXT wallet I have 230, in my broker wallet I already have 1,000. So I'm just gonna put in two, click admit 20, click two, click stake. And immediately it's gonna say, transaction success. It's going to refresh my page. And what's going to happen? It's going to say requested stake the tokens that I just staked. And so as soon as you stake the amount of tokens, you unlock your brokerage tab, then your accounts executive goes through it and makes sure everything is done properly, but you get access to everything automatically. So it's instant. Okay, credit card orders. Can you review some of the verticals in the platform? How can people transact? Definitely we'll do that. Yeah, I mean, someone's asking about 2FA. Yeah, we'll definitely introduce 2FA. For those of you that didn't know, we had 2FA working and we turned it off about 3.5 weeks ago because we're upgrading our backend security system. We're gonna turn it back early next week. A lot of people are asking about that. If anyone's asking about that, please let them know. It doesn't take that much effort to turn on 2FA. It's just something that we had to turn off for internal pen testing purposes, but we'll definitely turn it back on. Now we'll have it for sign up and upon register and upon withdrawals. Can you review some of the verticals in the platform and how we can help people transact? Okay, David, that's a hell of a question. If I started talking about each of these verticals, I can talk about each of them for days. So I'm gonna try to do it quickly. You know, there's tremendous amount of technical and non-technical literature videos and document writing, obviously, for each of these. I already talked about GX Trade. Let's talk about the money markets. I wrote the original white paper for one of the world's first money markets. If you go to moneymarkets.io, that's our decentralized domain for our money markets protocol. Essentially, what the money markets allow you to do is collateralize your cryptocurrency and borrow against it. What does that mean? That means if you have Bitcoin today and you need cash because you need to pay your bills, you can actually put your Bitcoin in a staking contract, a decentralized peer-to-peer capital pool, and borrow up to 50% of the value of your Bitcoin in another asset without having to give up that value of your Bitcoin. If you think Bitcoin's gonna go up, you don't wanna sell it. Right now, if you need money, you have to sell your Bitcoin. With the money markets, you put your Bitcoin in the money markets, like taking your house to a bank. Take your house to a bank, they don't force you to sell it. They let you borrow against it. It acts as collateral. There are lending companies in the crypto space that do that in a centralized fashion. We wrote a protocol that can do it in a decentralized fashion. We don't touch any of the funds. It is completely done in a decentralized architecture. I'm going to show you how it looks. Let's access the markets in using the DeFi. No, I'm not even inside of GX Nitrous. This is independent of GX Nitrous, which we then plugged into GX Nitrous for the OS purpose. But we own and built the moneymarkets.io. Look at this. This is a fully functional money markets. We haven't launched it. I mean, it's live. It functions perfectly. I've done a tremendous amount of tests. I haven't marketed yet, because there's so many things to market. But look at this. This is connected directly to my MetaMask. Nothing to do with global exchange, nothing to do with any of our wallets, directly on the Ethereum virtual machine. I've supplied $17 worth of Ether and I'm earning a 0.2% interest rate. I've already borrowed out of the money markets because obviously I played around with this after building it. I've borrowed basic attention token. I've taken that out of the market. I'm paying 26% interest because there's very little supply. I can do this now with multiple coins without any centralization, without giving up the value of my Ether. If Ether goes up, that's still my Ether value. An entire algorithm regulates the dynamic interest rates. This is the GX Markets, moneymarkets.io. And we've put this entire lending protocol, decentralized lending protocol, directly within GX Nitrous under money markets. But the great thing about what we do is we never take on something by ourselves. We built the GX markets, but we also integrated our competitors, Compound Finance, MakerDAO, collectively over $300 million worth of crypto already collateralized on those two platforms. Meaning you can manage all of your all of your debt positions for Compound Finance, GX markets, and MakerDAO right here. In other words, if you're a broker and your customer uses any of these platforms to stake, lend, trade, borrow crypto, you're getting paid. As a customer, you get to manage everything in one place. That's just one vertical. We haven't even talked about that. Nobody knows that we've done this. And in my opinion, it's the most revolutionary thing in money markets and in lending today. And that goes to show you how many of these type of weapons, how many of these type of verticals we have that we haven't even talked about because we're trying to slowly drip out the entire operating system. But that just gives you an example. Apart from trading, we've tackled very large protocol issues and worked with some of the biggest companies in the world to build this. Hope that gives you a small answer to your question. So what is the benefit if you never upgrade to being a GX broker? I mean, the benefit is really simple. Easiest way to get Bitcoin in the world. If you're in the United States, Coinbase and Cash App are probably still easier because you can link it to your bank account and use ACH services to debit your bank. We can't do that yet, but if we have domestic banks in the UK, you can do single day transfers. If you're outside of the United States, it's not even close. We have bank accounts, local subsidiaries in the United Kingdom, the European Union, Canada. where you can do these bank transfers to and fund your account and transfer out of. So within the United States, we're as competitive as they come. Outside of the United States, we're by far the most easy platform to get your money in and hedge between buying and selling crypto. And that's just the vault product. You never have to upgrade to be a broker. 99.9% of our customers will never become brokers. They are using the, in my opinion, the most seamless system for cryptocurrency. It's Coinbase Plus, because it's Coinbase Plus a bunch of stuff. Question about being grandfathered. If I have cryptos on another platform, what does it take to transfer? You just, David, I'm going to answer that question. You come to your Bitcoin or whatever your wallet's in the vault. It's kind of hard to say that because V and W are tongue twisters, and you click deposit. You look at the address that you want. Let's say it's Bitcoin. You get the address, you copy it, and it's just like anything else. That's how you transfer coins in. Question about being grandfathered in. Since we would be grandfathered in, come January, if we get 1,500 and decide to sell 1,000, bringing us back down to 500 that started with and enabled us to be grandfathered in, will we still keep our brokerage? Or will we be required to keep 1,000 GXT once we acquire that many? Fabulous question, Nathan. Many people have been asking me about this. Unfortunately, we haven't released a public answer on this. What we do know, however, so because your question is very nuanced, I cannot address it directly because we're going to make a press release about it, but I can tell you what things we have made public. Number one, if you sign up before January 1st, you can become a broker with only 500 coins, 450 coins to be exact, approximating about $500. People signing up after January 1st have to have 1,000. So that's stated. We've told everyone that. What Nathan's asking is if you buy more than 1,000, stake more than 1,000 and then sell some, you keep to keep your brokerage. That is a question that we're prognosticating right now. And I'm also working with my devs to figure out how that works from a staking perspective. But what I can say is, if you have more than 1,000, let's say you buy 1,500 coins, you can sell off 500. You can buy 10,000 coins and sell off 9,000. It's not an issue. That's completely doable. The one little nuance of your question I will address in a public announcement. When do you envision being able to deposit from Australian banks? Right now, we are onboarding a really large OTC provider in Australia. And once that's completed, they're actually waiting on us. When that's completed, you'll be able to make local deposits into Australia. That's the last Commonwealth country we haven't gone into, but we'll get there for sure. We will get there for sure. We'll also open up AUD trading for crypto really soon. So yeah. Can you remind how many max brokers there'll ever be? I love this question, my favorite question in the whole wide world. Let's take a look at the Ethereum network, shall we? Etherscan.io and go to GX token. You go to GX token, you can click right here. And what do you see? 350 million GXT. That's it. Full capacity, nothing more, nothing less. 350 million GXTs are in circulation. We have a governance policy on how those tokens have been released. 350 million are in circulation, most of which are held by the company. Now, with that being said, what implications does that have for the economics of GX token? Well, every broker needs to have 1,000 tokens. At 350 million divided by 1,000 is 350,000. So that if every broker only bought exactly how many tokens they need to become a broker, there would only be 350,000. Do I think that that will occur? Absolutely not. I think that people are hoarding coins so quickly right now. You guys have no idea how much people are hoarding coins. And because they're hoarding coins, they'll never end up being 350,000 brokers. They'll probably end up being about 250,000. So that's what I think. It'll never be, mathematically cannot be above 350,000, but I don't think it'll ever hit there. Yes, that's correct. Until January 1st, you can become a broker with 500 tokens. Actually, technically speaking, 450, but that's about $500. I think that's what you mean. What have you built into the OS to address security exposures, hacks, et cetera? So number one, there's like client-side security. I'm gonna do a course on this one day. Not one day, this week probably. But how exchanges actually secure themselves. Most people really don't have the faintest idea of how it works. So security is unfortunately not something that can be obtained by anybody or anyone. What you can do, however, is make it really not lucrative for someone to hack you. How do you do that? You do that by making assets unavailable to be hacked. So how do you do that? You either keep them in a decentralized architecture like a DEX, or you move them all offline like Coinbase does. If you move them all offline, now you better have a really good way of moving them offline. And you better have a really good way that that offline storage unit doesn't get penetrated. And so we've developed something on the back end that the clients will never see, but I'll definitely make a series of videos about. It's called GX ICE. And it's essentially our protocol for security. And we think it's really, 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 really remarkable. We've worked on it with about four different companies, four different security architecture firms. And it kind of restructures the way that centralized exchanges, centralized providers can do the security architecture. And we will offer a multifaceted approach where clients can keep it in a decentralized architecture using our Chrome extension, which then they would be controlling the private keys, as well as a centralized way using GX ICE that essentially allows them to tap into centralized security protocols. On the client side, it's 2FA, change your password every so often. We do random security checks. Last two weeks ago, we had to freeze a couple of accounts because they had suspicious behaviors, and then we had to unfreeze them once that we realized it wasn't suspicious. So basic client side stuff. There's not too much innovation on the client side. There's only innovation on the custodial side. We have a really profound one, I think. Great questions, guys. When you say app, you're talking about the mobile app? David? He said, can you talk about the app? I'm assuming you're talking about a mobile app because this is a web app. Yes. Well, let me see. Why talk about something when I can do a never before seen demo, which is on my phone? I just want to make sure it actually builds on my phone first. It does. This is our Vault app. Okay? Not the GX Nitrous app. The GX Nitrous app is huge. It's like all of these apps into one. It's like building a new Google Play Store. That's going to take some time. We've already started building it. We've sent some demos. That's going to take some time. But the Vault functionality, buy, sell, fund, withdraw, deposit crypto, and fiat currencies is obviously what everyone cares about. That's on my phone. And even with that, we've taken probably the most innovative approach I've ever seen when it comes to crypto, which is we're doing it through, oh man, I forgot the test username and password. Give me one second. I actually want to show you guys this. Let me see if I can pull that up for you. Or my developer here sent me a video. Can I just show that video? Okay, cool. I'm gonna just show that video, even better. All right. So yeah, the person that's asking, can you buy crypto? Yeah, you can do that immediately upon signing up, but there's four US states where you cannot buy with credit cards due to our payment processor. So on our website, Instacrypto Purchase, it outlines which states that is. If you live in those states or if your bank is in those states, unfortunately, you cannot use it. If you don't live in those states, you can take your shot. And why I say take your shot is you still obviously have the risk of making sure your bank approves the transaction, but definitely you can do it. Most of our credit card purchases are actually from the US, which is really funny because it has the most banned states, but that it is from there. We've had a lot of success. People have made like $19,000 transactions with credit card in the US. So what we wanted to do with the Vault app, because we knew that it's the simple to use app, we wanted to make it a little bit interactive. We wanted to see if there was some natural language processing that we can apply to it. Basically, natural language processing is the way for applications to understand English as opposed to just touches. And so like you might've seen it in some chat bots and stuff like that. And so we built our mascot. His name is Adam, named after Adam Smith. That's one of my economic heroes. And essentially what the Vault app actually is, it's a full chat interface that allows you to perform any transaction by click or by text. And so upon launching it, you'll actually engage with a fully interactive AI that will guide you through your crypto journey. And the goal is to make so that Adam allows to educate and onboard people that are really new into the space. Because again, this is not the full like trading app. This is more of the onboarding app into getting crypto and all of that stuff. This is what the early versions of it look like. We're looking to bump this out before Christmas. Obviously, that's a very optimistic goal. But that's what we're trying to shoot for. Maybe before the new year is a better example. So this is what it actually looks like. So when you open it, first time, it's going to introduce himself as Adam, and it's going to say, hey, boss, what do you want to do? You can log into your GX account and transact. You want to just talk to him about crypto? He can talk for days about crypto. Sign up for your free GX account or talk to an actual person, because Adam is still learning. Of course, you click that, then you'll talk to a human. Shorupan says, log in and transact. Okay, great. You're one of us. Please enter your email and password. Shorupan says, sure, I'm going to enter my email and password. Obviously, what we're talking about is your GX Nitrous username and password. And he's just entering a development environment text right now. When he enters it, clicks login. Now you're inside of the actual app. It's like, what do you want to do? And that's very important right there, because most people don't want to talk to a bot. They just want to do something. And look, immediately when you open the app, once you've logged in, it says, what do you want to do? You can just say nothing. I just want to log in. I'll come back later. Perform a transaction, get market data, get account data. I'm going to say, perform a transaction. He's going to say, what do you want to do? Top up one of your currency accounts, withdraw from crypto, buy crypto, sell crypto, swap crypto, send crypto, receive crypto. I'm going to say buy crypto. And I'm going to select which coin, Ethereum. And it's going to give me all the information about Ethereum, price data, market data, the ability to buy it, the ability to sell it, and being able to tap into it, buy it with my account balance, all of that fun stuff. And this is just the inception of Adam. Adam is going to become essentially the prolific artificial intelligence that powers all of the different market data analysis behind global exchange. That app, I think, will do a lot to change. The big thing about natural language processing that most people don't understand is obviously the fact that it can be done in any language, not just English. See, this app right here is English-based. Most of the literature for financial applications are done in English, but when you're talking about a natural language processing artificial intelligence, in theory, he can talk in any language and make it explain natively in that language. So this can be a really big app for non-English speaking countries. And think about as a broker, if you can just send the app to anyone and also onboard them that way, it'll be pretty impressive. So, yep. I mean, you guys got a lot out of me there. You guys got like money markets, the app. I don't know why. I think it's only because I slept for like 45 minutes. I might be a little overly enthusiastic. But really, I think it's a great webinar. This one's going to be definitely the new flagship webinar to go to. I'm going to post it on YouTube. I'll have one of my team members do that. Guys, get back to the person that got you in. Sign up for GX Checkout. It's free. Doesn't require any of your data in terms of like KYC. Just gets basic information. Play around with the account. Break it. Tell us what you hate. Tell us what you love. And let's see what we can improve on as we head toward 2020. Make this a really strong 2020 for all of you guys. Thank you so much for your time. Again, I'm your gracious host, Shorupan, and I hope that you were able to glean something on this webinar that will allow you to really ignite your finances. Thank you so much.